And I've been watching a lot of those while eating, which includes right now, since I still have one slice of pizza in front of me, so stuff will probably not start up immediately, but I was looking for something here. What was I looking for? Could it be this? Oh, hey, look, would you look at that, Mike? Some, oh, he's not. No, he uses that other one, the one from the Mr. Amazing intro, doesn't he? So I guess I could get that one if I wanted to keep up that joke, but why bother? Also, today, or well, today, right now, 4 minutes and 20 seconds ago, when I decided to start the stream. Apparently the Hitbox dashboard says that my stream configuration right now is bad because I have the keyframe interval set to 1 instead of 2, but when I go into the settings it says that the keyframe interval actually is 2, so I don't know what Hitbox is on about. Also, I apparently set my, oh yeah, I lowered my bitrate a bit because it's not like my streams are like super amazing high quality, and apparently having a higher bitrate is one of the biggest contributors to having a higher file size in the end for the recording, so I turn it down a notch, which Hitbox also doesn't like, but it's not raising as much of a fuss about it. And it doesn't help that, you know, bitrate issues aside, I've had some bizarre frame rate issues with OBS, but apparently the two biggest fixes for that I've discovered are changing the affinity cores to lower them on whatever the program that's causing the issue is, or just using game capture if using window capture is what's causing it, because apparently in order of like impact on the and performance. Apparently the most impactful form of capture that OBS has is monitor capture followed by window capture followed by game capture, which is supposed to be the most optimal one, but I call shenanigans on that because back when I did one of my first test streams with this new computer, one of the games I tested was New Thief. And I tried game capture with that and it ran horribly, and I tried monitor capture and it ran a little bit slower than I would have wanted, but it ran better than with window capture, so I don't know what to tell you. But anyway, speaking of games, I think it's time to begin this, or continue this journey, I should say, with this game that I've already run, and yet its Steam is now asking me to agree to the license agreement again. Seems to have been particularly trigger happy with that lately. And it starts on full screen, even though, oh boy, I'm pretty sure I did tell it not to the last time I ran it, because I ran it for the stream. And now I gotta wait through all these lovely disclaimers at the beginning, and health and safety notices and such. So that I can go into. No, wrong one. Wrong one. Oh, Christ. There. So that I can go here. Just gonna use a mouse now. And change the video settings and go to advanced video and change the resolution to 4x3, which I think is that. And change it to windowed. I could make it borderless, but I don't actually know how it works. What I see in borderless is for people with like multi-monitor setups, which I don't have. I don't even have an optimal single monitor setup right now. And tell it yes, I don't want it to stay that way. Oh, shoot. And also tell the music player that isn't from the game to get out of the way. And move the taskbar, and okay, let me see if I can make this visible at least. Alright, here we are. Hang on a minute. Is that set to stretch? Yeah, it is. But if I set it to ignore aspect ratio as well, it stretches it. Okay, that's not good. No, change that back. There we go. And it's set to fit the screen, so in theory that should be the right way. So, here we go. Actually, I don't know how I'm gonna do this exactly. Guess I'm gonna put that there and... Okay, yeah, if I do that... I put the window there and I put the OBS window there. Okay, now I can see everything. There we go. Well, it's time to continue with Life is Strange, aka not Twin Peaks. And I think that when I stopped playing this first time, I had just begun with the first episode. And we made it to this place, which is Chloe's room, and... And am I crazy, or am I gonna have to start this room from the beginning? I think we're gonna have to start this room from the beginning.
Different than the last time you saw it. It's cool. At least we can chill out. This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fearer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
It looks that way. Well, I see that... Well, I'm using game capture for the sake of getting a decent OBS frame rate, but... Apparently there's some minor screen tearing going on, or it looks like it's going to do that. Is there an option for that? I have the feeling there isn't, but... Pretty much everything on high. And it runs decently, but apparently there's no... Actually, there is VSync, what the hell? Oh well. You know what, never mind, just learn to ignore that. And already did this part. And I think the only choices here were break the snow globe or not, and... You did determine that...
I had to dig through Chloe's crap.
That wasn't gonna happen, so... Let's just get things back up to speed with this. Which I can't skip because he doesn't remember that I already did this also. What the hell is going on outside? Oh, for fuck's sake. Well, apparently, there's either...
Hey, give me that! Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
Some kind of rock concert or... fake rock concert going on outside due to the loud... overdriven guitar sounds coming from the...
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell. Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
Oh boy. Oh, well, that's nice.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks... Your mom tried to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life.
Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Well, at least the CD is permanently in our possession now, also. Let me close this thing real quick, so that stuff doesn't get in the way. And this. And what was the other thing? Oh, yeah. This right here. And maybe tweak some of these a little bit, since apparently I'm getting some frame rate hits, which oddly enough didn't happen before. Well, this is time they're on the actual game and not on OBS. Do I need this? I don't think so. Do I need this? What effects? Just put that. Yeah. Freaking FX, low. There. Since in my experience, FXA is one of the biggest frame rate killers. And we do seem to be doing a little better now, alright. So, time to turn the power strip on. And put the CD on. And see what follows from there. Answer is more of this music, even though I didn't want to admit it. Well, less admit it and more have it in any way. Since I can't say I'm the biggest fan of acoustic guitars.
Anyway,
which is obviously not the case for this game.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Oh yeah, her camera broke. I forgot about that. And that is our next objective indeed, go and fix the camera. And I guess something else I should do is go into this real quick so I can be aware of any choices that might be coming up. Because I was doing the thing where the chat makes choices for this game. And just like last time, there's only a couple of people in here right now, which is great. So where is this thing? God damn it. Where are the screenshots for this game? Alright, minor technical difficulties going on here, folks. So hey, this music. Which isn't really apropos anymore, since, you know, I already beat that game. Oh boy, are they under sea? Why are they under sea? Or not. Okay, let me try a different approach. Hmm. Ah, here we go. Yes, exactly this right here. All of them? No, not all of them. Here we go. Okay, is this? Yeah, there we go. This is the one for episode one, and I want to know if I... Well, I would have wanted to know if I had this on local storage, but I guess not. Oh well. So, let me have a look at this. This here window, which is too small. Okay, the bird, the evidence, and the files. Okay, I think I have all of them. Right, has that ended? Right, here we go. So now back to our regularly scheduled programming right after I get the windows in the correct order of visibility. Alright, here we go. We walk over here. I can't remember if it's here or in the other bedroom, which is in this place. We can witness a scene.
This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today.
With that bird.
Oh shit! Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it.
Didn't look like it was going that fast, but I guess birds' calls are very fragile, so... Well, I think I can see where this is going. Do we save the bird or not? And I have the feeling I should have... better option for Paul music. I guess I can just switch back to this window and see how the music has apparently stopped, which I'm not opposed to, but in this case it doesn't exactly work in my favor. Oh, hey, it actually shows up over the chat now. It didn't do that before. I guess he must have changed the dashboard. Alright, we have one vote for Save the Bird, which I guess is Redbird, so... 30 seconds, and if anyone else is around, now's the time.
Joyce still works at the diner. Is her husband a cop? Poor Chloe.
So yeah, we don't know who Chloe's stepdad is, do we?
Uh-oh. The prices are late on their bills.
The prices are late on their bills. So they're not doing that great. And if we look
here... Joyce looks happy. Chloe's stepdad might not be a douchebag after all.
Yeah, we've seen that guy. Also, I'm pretty sure the 30 seconds are up, so Save the Bird it is. Oh, two votes for Save the Bird. I think I just saw that. So let's... rewind time. Like we know how to do. And see if we can open the window. Apparently this action will have consequences, but I couldn't tell you what they are. Did the bird make it inside? Yeah, I guess so. No, it's inside the house.
You've been resurrected, birdie. Fly, be free.
And well, we could have left that bird there, but... I guess you could suggest that by letting that bird live.
Act or die, a 21st century survival guide.
That Whoa, messed with the
self-help.
Predetermined entropy of the universe or some such thing. And it might seem like a small action, but the small actions like that will gradually build up. And wait until you see the end result. Well, let's go downstairs. I'm pretty sure that's the last... well, we could have looked around a little more. There's like hair dye in the bathroom, but nothing else important.
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days.
I think we established that already. Also, hang on a minute. Let me see if I can figure out.
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days.
How loud the game is, it's not that loud, so let me raise that a little and see if that helps. Well, I don't know if we can... if Chloe's stepdad is around or if Joyce is. Oh, man. Got some SMSs from Kate. Oh, we took a picture of when she was being molested by David. Or not molested in the bad sense, but I guess harassed by David. Instead of helping her out, but I guess at least we apologized. So what else we got here?
Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore.
Okay, I guess it helps that you say that because we don't really have any frame of reference ourselves, but... but it is helpfully provided. Oh boy. Game? Hang on a minute. There we go.
I'd love to go to Paris too. At this rate, they'll be lucky to get to Portland.
Yeah, I don't think a lot of pennies in a jar are gonna get you to Paris from... where is this, Oregon? Yeah, Oregon. It's on that budget.
Joyce still works at
Tubal's. On 2013.
Penny. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon.
We haven't been there yet, have we? No, I don't think so. I came straight from the academy to this place because...
I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever.
Game just started. Also, my keyboard is being a bastard right now.
Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking.
Okay. Sometimes turning it off and on again helps, but right now it apparently helps 50% of the time. So what is there outside? For sure we're in mostly in observation time right now.
I can feel autumn pushing out the summer.
How? Is it cold? I've never lived in a suburb, so I can't relate to any of this. I'd just like to point that out.
Oh, I loved this swing. William made it just for me and Chloe.
Well, what if we sit down on the swing and reflect for like 3 minutes?
What do you truly want to do when you grow up?
Max, I'm already grown up. What about you?
Travel. That would be awesome. Explore the world, go far from here.
Far from me? Thanks a lot, dude.
Dude, you would totally come with me. I need a bodyguard for our adventures.
I would be like Lara Croft, except real. That would be majorly cool.
Totally. We'd have cars and boats and planes all over for instant escape. And no adults could tell us what to do.
Count me in. What would you do while I was bodyguarding you?
Maybe take pictures of our adventures. I would love to be a photographer. As if I ever could be.
What are you talking about? Max, you are a photographer. Your pictures could be in a museum. Someday they will. I believe in you.
Yeah, I guess you could say that. When you define a profession by people who do something as opposed to people who do something professionally, or, well, professionally in the sense that they get paid for it. So, someone who takes pictures is a photographer, and someone who writes is a writer, someone who paints is a painter. Whether they get paid for it is a different story. And I guess, kind of appropriately, Slimebeast put up a video, I think yesterday or today, one of those days.
Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking.
I think he put up 2 videos, actually. One yesterday and one today, because he had an issue with not Mr. Creepypasta, that was a while ago, but Creeps McPasta.
Hey, I remember that stain. Chloe and I knocked over Joyce's wine bottle and we scrubbed forever, but it never came out. We got so busted.
Can't get out a wine stain from a carpet in 2013. Alright, I guess science has failed us. But he had a small, I guess... what's the word I'm looking for?
I should be able to find the tools I need here.
Exchange of differences, I guess. Not really a fight, since both parties weren't really aggressive with Creeps McPasta. Because he had made some videos about his creepypastas that were monetized, which he didn't like. And apparently, about a year ago, told him to either get rid of the ads or put them down, and he stopped communicating, and... And after the video came up with the whole conversation thing, the videos were apparently finally taken down. So I guess that was resolved, but that was the first thing. The other thing was a distinction, I guess, between a reader and a narrator. Wherein a reader is pretty much someone that reads something with pretty much no changes, which is what most creepypasta readers are. Versus a narrator, which is the leading voice of a story, and I guess can or has to be unique to be called that, according to him. So it can't just be a reader. And yet most people who read creepypastas call themselves narrator for credibility, I guess. Just some food for thought. Anyway, let's continue.
Chloe's stepdad is a veteran and a security guard? He must really hate her.
Well, you should know who he is by now, Max. I'm kind of surprised that you haven't made any comments on that, but apparently, yeah. Security guy apparently was a soldier. And will not let people forget that. As is often
Chloe's
the case, I come to understand.
Security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get?
This is the first time ever that I've heard about this. And this guy. Also, he has guns because America, of course.
One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat.
And one of the guns is missing. Or maybe you know, there's also the possibility, I guess, that he has a case like this, but he can't fill it up with guns because he doesn't have enough of those. But then why would there be a space between two of them? So I guess it does make sense.
Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them.
Or can I?
That does not look stable.
Yeah, that design is questionable if you ask me, but I'm guessing it's based on a real design.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
Are you sure? We could, I don't know, get down and, you know, be on the floor and reach out with your arm. I mean, I kind of have to do that every so often when something falls under my bed, but
yes, here's some ancient cardboard.
But I guess we're doing this Mystery of Time and Space style.
Man, I should have done that before they fell.
Yep, I should have. Oh well. But I can't do anything about that. Oh, wait. So let's do this the right way. And there we go. So now we can get the tiny precision screwdrivers,
yes,
I guess.
You have mad skills, Max.
And I guess we need to find a surface to work in.
I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
We could have a look around, though.
This must belong to Chloe's stepdad. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
Well, don't you want to look around in it anyway? I mean, what do you have to lose by doing that? There's nobody else around. Nope, no tools there. Wait a minute. I think some of the cheese and crackers stuff on the back. Alright, never mind. I thought that might have been like a reference to Wallace and Gromit, where they have shelves full of crackers, but no, they don't look that similar. Also, we can discover this.
Should I switch this on? Decisions.
So we don't know quite what it is yet, but well, we could not do that at all. And walk away, or we could try to find out what this thing is about. So let's hear it. And while that is going on, I guess minute and a half or so, Let me see, do I have any music that would be appropriate for this polling thing? We got one vote for Snoop right now. So this, I guess, I'll do something with this sort of tune, but I don't think this one's that appropriate. This one, though. Can't find anything else. Yeah, no, maybe not. Well, maybe this, but nah. Oddly enough, I've took a quick look at Toman. We got a 50-50 split. So it looks like it's gonna be time to find that RNG. That thing I used last time to resolve this. Since I'm pretty sure there's only two people here right now. So let me see. I need to make something else visible. What about... what about this? This isn't even alright now. This right here. So, the choices are, should I snoop or should I... what the hell? Why did you do that? Alright. Or not. Okay, one is for snoop, two is for don't snoop. Okay, I guess we're walking away from this. Oh well. I guess that's that. So let's rewind time so that we never even opened that cupboard in the first place. And just walk away. And I guess it's not really perceptible, but if you hold shift, you walk like 1.5 times faster, which is a little bit more noticeable when you're outdoors, but we got what we were looking for, so I guess we're not looking for any more trouble. Tools.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera.
Okay, let's, okay, we don't even have to do that, it just does it for us. So, time to finish my pizza.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Are you shitting me? That asshole's everywhere. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
Now tell me the truth, Max.
No, man. Well, I'm pretty sure we can't bullshit our way out of this one, so... and this isn't a significant choice either, so...
I was there, hiding in the corner. Damn, you're a ninja. A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo. That is so badass. Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
I'm sorry, what? I wasn't sure.
I wasn't sure. I know I look a lot different. I was scared, too. I couldn't see straight.
I don't blame you, Max.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Well, yeah.
just a bit.
There's no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Well, I'm pretty sure we didn't, but I don't know about these two answers. Like who?
Like who?
Like anybody. Stop stalling, sister.
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max.
See, I kind of forgot about the principal, but oh well. Well, he doesn't seem like he's a psychopath like the other kids, so how bad could it get?
No, it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
Alright, so that's going on. I finally finished my pizza, so... So at least there's that. I guess I can take a photo of this. Which, you know, who wouldn't? Put in this situation.
This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on! Rock out, girl!
Yeah, I heard RDAW on that sentence for sure.
Yo, turn it off! Turn it off!
Oh boy. Apparently someone else is here.
I told you, stop blasting that punk shit!
Dude, the music's not even on! Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh boy.
In the fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
So yeah.
What's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay?
So there's actually two
find a place to hide now.
Differences in this situation. We can try to hide in the closet.
Give me a minute.
Don't get smart.
Or not.
Let me in now.
We can't really hide under the bed. I don't believe.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe.
I'm not a kid anymore. I can't hide under the bed. Where else?
I'm giving you exactly 3 seconds to open the door. One.
Well, what if we just hang back here?
Shit!
What's going on in here?
Oh,
why is she here?
None of your business.
No, that didn't apparently make
like
a difference.
Strangers here.
Stop freaking! She's not a stranger! This is my friend!
Great. Another one of your friends.
So, actually, wait a minute. Can we do anything? No, we can't.
One of my guns is missing.
Until this dialogue scene ends.
Did you take it?
Oh god, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been token up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth, that's an order.
It's not my pot. It's from Max.
Oh boy.
Is this true?
Well, that happens. And, you know, I don't think it's possible to rewind after this point, so I guess it became this choice. So let's see. Oh boy. So shall we go along with that and pretend that the pot is ours, or shall we tell the truth and rat out our friend? Oh yeah, that. Okay, no, apparently I don't want to play music from Mafia because everyone thinks that it's not possible to have that without some unspecified party laying claim to it online. I don't think that'll be the case for this though. And it's kind of fitting. So let's see. I got one vote for taking the blame right now. 30 seconds. Alright, two votes take the blame, so I guess that's what we're gonna do. Now the weird thing is, I'm pretty sure there's actually a way to hide if you know what you're doing, but I didn't know how to do that the first time I played the game. And I didn't know how to do that this time, so... sorry, what was the... alright.
Yeah. My pot.
So you're bringing drugs into my
so
home?
I don't know.
How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Oh, you're on a roll today. Between the fire alarm and now this? You don't have anything smart to say now, do you?
Get the hell away from her! I have proof you hassled Kate Marsh today.
What? What are you talking about?
I have surveillance proof. Now please leave us alone.
Okay, Chloe. You know everything. And Max, if I find you here again, it will be the last time.
Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win.
Was it though?
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Did you hear what happened in there?
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody. Even Chloe.
Well,
I have to think about my own future.
Well, I'm afraid you have to live with what you did there. You see, that's how it works. This is real life. This isn't some game.
Hard to believe Chloe was my BFF just 5 years ago.
And you don't have time powers, so... let's not... say anything about that either. And by the way, apparently even if you do manage to hide, which I don't know how you do that, you have a choice to come out and defend Chloe or do nothing, so you know, same difference. I'm going to assume that if I would have hidden, it would have been the same result, had the same result. But who knows. Now, I'm pretty sure this is the last scene in the first episode, but there's four more after this, so... oh yeah, this dough. It's kind of oddly symbolic.
Totally reminds me of when we were kids. Come on, Slowpoke!
Hold on!
And shows up in a few places.
So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
Well, are there that many paths leading up to the lighthouse? I mean, what are the odds, realistically, that it's the same path?
I feel like I'm in my nightmare again.
Really? I don't know. I'm not really seeing the resemblance. Where's the giant vortex in the distance? That's a cliff. That's not a giant tornado. Also, I'm pretty sure we can't leave because there's either a gate or just an automatic thing saying not to.
They haven't updated this sign since the 1980s.
Well, are these types of signs usually updated often? I mean, especially in places like this.
People can be such pigs.
Could pick it up. I can offer that as a choice. Okay. No, apparently there's a gate. Fence.
That old fence is part of the landscape now. The path behind it leads to the parking lot.
It's Well, I guess it's part of the landscape in the same sense that the landscape could change very easily if someone came along with a bulldozer. But I think we're just gonna climb up there. I think there's a few pictures to take with, like,
lucky
squirrels.
They can always escape.
Also, what the hell is that warring guy want? What? Thanks for today, and you still have you tell me your big secret. What big secret? Also equals kick. I guess it's catching on. Or it has been for a couple of years now.
Oh my god, I forgot all about this. Too bad I can't rewind that far back.
What does that say? Max and Chloe Booth Pirates 2008. Ken looks like Naok, though. If you look at it in a certain way, it's an odd way to make an X. Freaking cursive. Also, who writes in cursive for a tree stump carving? I have to question how that was possible.
Wowzer, Chloe drew that to mark our tree fort, so we'd always be able to find each other in case of emergency.
Oh boy. Why can't I see what any of those landmarks are? I mean, I guess that's the academy, but and that's a water tower, but what about the rest of these? Not Bigfoot. They know where Bigfoot is at any given time. They made it a landmark marker. Oh boy, what do we got here? Trust no one.
How long has that been here?
Probably not that long. I mean, I'm guessing it rains often.
Looks like the youth of Arcadia Bay still come up here to party. I never made it.
I don't know about you, but it seems like sitting on a brick like that would be very uncomfortable, but... And speaking of Bigfoot...
Clearly. The Bigfoots are everywhere.
Oh boy, also, hang on a minute. There we go.
Too bad it's locked. I remember racing up and down the steps.
Don't lighthouses have machinery, though? Guess it would make sense to keep it locked. Why wasn't it before? They just not care? Was it because of the terrorists? Did they win? Okay, no.
This would be a nice photo of Chloe, framed by the sun.
Hint, hint. What is that? That button? That pin? Like, okay, I seriously can't see what it is when it's that small. So let's try to forget that it exists.
Have a seat, Pete.
You're in a good mood. Yeah, I guess he is. It's not even sarcastic.
You're in a good mood? Seeing my step dork get played makes me happy.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
Am I glad we took his photo, or did I feel weird? Well, so I guess I felt weird because of... I guess I impeded her from helping Kate, but I guess I'm glad.
I'm glad I took his photo with Kate. Just in case.
Why was he all up in her shit?
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
Take a peek at what? What files? I just kind of quietly walked away.
What files?
David stashes his secret X files in there. I saw them once, but he secures them now.
He kind of creeps me out. I bet the truth is out there in his files.
Most likely, hey. But it's good you didn't find his files. He would go ballistic. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Okay. So I guess we want to know for sure if there are surveillance cameras in the house, but... What's her secret? What's Nathan's secret?
What's Nathan's secret?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit at the laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
Okay.
What?
I guess that's your secret.
He had a bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe.
Now, I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Oh boy.
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
Well, I don't want to pry, so...
So, what about you and Nathan?
We went to his room at Blackwell. We drank, and I laughed at his rich kid bullshit. He was one step ahead and put something in my beer.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Well, that was fucked up, but I don't know what I can do.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
Well, he's still dangerous, but if we can't trust the principals, how can we trust the police?
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Oh, good thing you notified the principal. I feel safer already.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
Well, still waiting for your answer.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max.
Your subtitles look different.
This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Oh boy. You're still gonna be saying that in a few days. It's also a surprise. Of the deer is here is as well. And also we are no longer up top, apparently, but back on the path.
Is Chloe still up there? I have to find out.
Oh boy. Also
I have
a rock is in the way, but I guess conveniently we can't die because whenever something like that happens, time just automatically stops. So we can't take the closest path. And we can't really proceed past this point because of this tree, but thanks to the spatial consistency that we have, we can just rewind time really far back and hurry past. But oddly enough though, I think this is the only like puzzle sequence where old spatial consistency thing is really important to remember because of stuff like this. Where it matters where you are at one particular moment, but if you can't push yourself forward through time. Nowhere is that more evident than with this bit. Because now there's no way forward. No matter where we go. So how do we do this? Well, obviously, stand right here. Rewind time. It's the only small window of time between when the boat hits and when that falls. Question is, what do we do once we're on the other side? Actually, I don't remember. Check the bench, I guess. Nope, the newspaper.
October 11th? Is this Friday? That's only 4 days away!
Oh boy. Yep, tornadoes will do that.
That tornado is headed straight for the town.
Are you sure? Maybe it's going away from it,
Chloe,
but...
you're here! I'm back! Oh my lord, this is real, it's real! Oh man, this sucks!
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years, which is so...
No, no, I saw it! I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had the same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But Ty, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game.
I already said that.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day.
Oh, but wait.
What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning.
This is all the proof I need. So yeah, this is turning into Tumblr, I guess. In more ways than one. And we have to listen to this, I guess. Why is that guy there? Is that a thing people often do in high schools, in private high schools, in wealthy, semi-wealthy US suburban towns? Stay after hours. There are not many volcanoes in Oregon, though. Also, I don't know about the lyrics of this song. I mean, if you're talking about the past, then obviously you were younger. I mean, 10 seconds ago I was younger. I'm younger now than I am now. See, it's a bit redundant, so one state north in, what, Washington State? So, yes. But that's apparently episode 1. The Life is Strange theme, so let's look at the choices. So yeah, apparently you can hide in this sequence, like I said, but I don't know how it's done. I'm guessing that you like try to open the closet and then when stuff comes pouring out, you rewind time and you know how to avoid that the next time, but I don't actually know. And, well, apparently the most popular choice in this scenario is coming out of hiding after hiding. Also, for the minor choices, we could have read David's files, and we could have left evidence or not, regardless of whether we read them or not, but we didn't. Didn't break the snow globe, we saved the bird, we wrote on the RV. Didn't touch the photos and all of this stuff around the academy. So what's next? Do we actually get a preview? I think we do, yeah. Because why not? Also, I think at the end of every one of these episodes, we do get these scrolling text on the left. Continue the story with the next episodes, and if you hadn't bought the season pass, you better buy it now. Oh wait, you don't have to because everything's already out. But, well, there's one message in particular that I'm not seeing right now. Can I say anything different? No, I guess not. It's, well, maybe here, but it does say something like, if you're affected by any of the real-life issues discussed in the game, please go to the website and seek counseling near you, or something like that. And I figure, you know, is this really the best example of that?
In the previous episode of Life is Strange...
What about when Requiem for a Dream came out? And people realized then that maybe bad stuff is bad. What about train spotting?
See everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey, leave him alone! Max? Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Wait! Is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max, tell me everything.
Also, I just noticed that I had the microphone turned off. I was just basically saying that I was looking up the... Or not looking up. Just bringing... I guess pulling up the choices for this episode. So I know when they're coming up. Also, I guess I haven't mentioned this far. If I sound a little bit different now, it's because... I kind of got a cold around last Sunday. And oddly enough, I've... It's not completely gone by now, but it's kind of in its last leg. But the weird thing is that before that, for the longest time, I had like a feeling in my throat like it was congested or inflamed. And it was kind of affecting the range that I had, if that makes any sense. With speaking in like a high or low pitch, or speaking quietly, but apparently the cold helped clear that up, so... It's odd how that works like that. And here's another hipster-sounding song that I don't recognize. You'll find that there are a lot of those in this. Does she have a freaking Keep Calm and Carry On carpet?
I am so wrecked after staying up all night. I could use my rewind to catch a few more Z's, but maybe I better save my strength.
Yeah, that would kind of defeat the purpose, wouldn't it? No, let's get up. Thank you. I think you have to actually manually make her get up. Okay.
Being a superhero is dirty work. I need a shower.
Why did you buy that? Oh well. Oh yeah, the plant is here. Well, before we make the first choice... You there, Mad Max? Oh boy. No emoji. Those aren't even emoji, though. Apparently Chloe doesn't like emoticons, which aren't emoji because they literally are just text characters. The whole point of emoji is that they're like special graphics that appear in place of text characters, so can't say I agree with that terminology, but oh boy. So I guess we got some new pre-ready SMS messages in this. Hang on. Alright. Some tall tales about a Blackwell honor student. Hope you didn't forget to water the plant. Yeah, about that. Okay, I think that's actually the same, yeah, carried over from the previous episode.
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again.
Yeah.
Like no time has passed.
Well, while you think about that, what shall we do? Shall we water it or shall we not? Do we go for the special jewel like in Luigi's Mansion, or do we forget about it? Well, actually, what else do we got? What's this?
This picture will capture this crazy historic moment in your life.
This particular one instance worth.
No smiling. Moment. Take your power seriously.
Yeah, okay. Yep, that face screams to me, I have time powers and I don't know what to do with them.
Whew. I could get lost doing time travel research.
Well, she already did, you see.
I can't keep my eyes open, but I know there's a scientific answer.
Burn your clock. Toy. I don't know why you would write this and this and stuff like that and leave it on, but... But I guess she must, because it's there. So what do we got? Water the plant, alright. Well, time to water it.
Drink up. It's got electrolytes.
No, it doesn't. Fucking hell. So... Watering a plant will have consequences, yeah. Look, I just touched the top of the cap of my drink. That will have consequences. And it's not even a lie. Oh boy. Actually, wait a minute. These things didn't change, did they? No, they didn't. Alright. Just checking.
Whoa! Hello, zombie face. This is what happens when you research quantum physics all night.
Yeah, I kinda question how you're able to do that all night and still get up in time before class, assuming there is class today. Now, what is this? Oh, okay. No way they give you a separate means to do that, but... Or this, I should have realized that's what that was. Kinda stopped reading the synopsis after a while because it's just, you know, stuff you've already seen. It does have a few references to other media and such here and there, but it's mostly just a summary, guess in case you forget what you've been seeing, but I never really needed it. What the fuff? Oh, fluff. I am an other one. Okay. What is this?
Just because some ass pranked a girl's shampoo bottle and her hair fell out, we have to stay for our toiletries. So, summer camp.
It's okay. Does that always happen at summer camp? That's another thing I absolutely cannot relate to.
Uh-oh. I wonder if I'll ever wear a watch again.
But what's wrong with the frog watch? Also, where is the pointer? Okay, there it is.
Good morning, Chloe. I hope you slept well.
Can we
now, shall
get
I be
dressed?
My Gucci shirt with the Vuitton jacket?
We cannot get dressed. I guess we have to go to the shower first.
Would Man Ray call them selfie portraits?
Okay, that's something else that was already there. Now, before I leave this room, let me take a quick look at this. Okay. Where's this? Oh, right. Never mind. Okay, there's some minor choice coming up. But it's outside this room.
I better not leave my shower supplies.
Well, why not take them?
Okay, Max. Let's hit the showers now.
Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry.
Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it, consider it done.
Well, I hope you don't mind me just standing here and staring while you talk about that.
Ow!
Oh boy. Well, I guess I meant two choices. So guess what we get to do again? We get to either, warn this girl that the toilet paper roll is coming, or not.
Ow!
So, let's do it. And see what else is here in the hallway. In the meantime. Well, yep, she's still missing that Rachel Amber.
The Vortex Club are such pigs. I'm glad I pissed them off.
Oh boy, what you guys looking at?
Whatever they're watching must be hot stuff.
Talking on those bros.
Talking about Kate.
We shouldn't be watching this.
Everybody's seen it by now.
All right.
There's Brooke, looking smarter than everybody.
Why are you looking at each other's hands if you each have a smartphone? Oh well. Okay. So what do we got? One vote for warn her. So what's going on in this room? I actually don't know. Why are you doing that?
I've never seen Dana this bouncy and happy without a pot of coffee.
How do you know she hasn't had one?
Hi, Dana. How are you?
Much better than yesterday. I'm glad we talked.
I guess I am too.
Me too. I know it's good to just talk about this stuff.
You're almost psychic. I felt like you knew everything anyway. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max. So, are you coming to the party or not?
I'm sorry I missed what party, so I guess.
Why the fuck not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max. After this, you'll be ready for a rave.
It does sound like fun. Now I have to go contemplate my party future.
Okay. So let's look at the very... The very visible.
Speaking of Halloween, look at all this makeup. At least Dana knows how to use it.
Also, what do we got with the poll? Warn her. Alright. Alright, let's do it. I'd have tried to switch back to this, have we? So that I can see everything. Oh boy. So back in time ago, I guess we're undoing that conversation. And no, we're not gonna speed her, we have to warn her about what's coming. But first it has to unhappen. Alright, there we go.
Alyssa, can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy. Wow, now that was close. Thank you, Max.
Well, seeing how it's a roll of toilet paper, I don't think it would have hurt that much, but... Alright. Well, at least it doesn't loudly announce this action will have consequences now. Just shows the butterfly. Oh boy. Oh, here's Kate. What's up with her?
Kate is not good. I wish David would get off her crack, as Chloe would say.
Okay.
Oh, hey, Kate. Sorry about yesterday.
Yeah, I'm sorry you didn't do anything to help. But you're just like everybody else here.
It's not true. I wanted to help, but...
Whatever. It's done. By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Okay, sudden shift in tone.
Yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
I forgot what I was saying 5 seconds ago.
Can you bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
Well, I guess I hate you, but I guess I can be nice. Kate, are you losing it?
After my shower, I'll bring her book back, and that'll be a good excuse for us to chat. Maybe just talking to her friend will help her feel better?
Hmm.
The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you.
Pretty sure I saw this before, and maybe actually it works the other way around for me. Getting a flu shot is the only way for me to not get the flu.
I'm good to flow. Thanks.
Okay.
Otter power? I'm so not there.
It's okay. Hmm. Are swim teams really that big? I mean... Well, let's go shower, I guess. Didn't even think my high school had a swim team. Or any kind of sports team for that matter. And if they did, it must have been a mystery because they never announced it. Certainly not like that.
What's up, Kate?
School.
That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel. We ran all the
didn't
way
realize.
Up to the desk, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate or Max.
Right, I don't know why Max, but...
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in
action. You are such an evil biatch. I love
it. Okay, I guess to order it, what, lipstick? Okay, I don't really see how you would have room for clothes in a tidy store like this, but I guess Max did. I guess you just get out soaked and change in a room? I don't know how any of this works, because I don't think there are any universities or high schools or anything with a dorm in this country, but...
Is that the link to Kate's video? Damn, Victoria is so fucking mean.
Kate'svideo.com, no triple W or anything. So I think the choice is pretty obvious here. Do we leave that there, or do we erase it? Also, I just noticed that it also says trust no one over on the towel dispenser on the right. Oh boy. No, that's... Well, I guess it's in tune with the previous one, but maybe not. Could replay this, but maybe I could look for a different... Maybe not. It's maybe this. Maybe not. Also, so far we only got one vote for do we erase it. And it's about hit 130, and it just did, so I guess I'm using the RNG thing one more time. So one will be for erase it, and two for don't erase it. Okay, I guess we're erasing it. So let's go back in and be a good person.
Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Is that such a good job? I guess it is. You would have tried to make it so that no trace of that was left in the mirror, but... I guess it comes off in your hand, but then again, you know, there's a sink right in front of you, so it's not like it's gonna stay there forever.
Hello? Water? Sorry, I forgot.
Really? Like, I remember that happening before, but I'm pretty sure that's not how the plumbing works in this apartment. That's no longer a problem. You can flush, and it won't make the hot water disappear, or anything. Or at least not in my experience. So, time to get dressed, I suppose. Oh boy.
Ugh, no fucking way! This is not why I came to Blackwell.
Oh, and I still right. I forgot about that.
Kate's book.
It's conveniently covered up by the game window over the OBS preview, so I completely failed to notice that. Hello? Ah, there we go. So yeah, apparently someone's threatening Max.
Oh shit. Nathan's revenge. Even Chloe told me not to go to the principal.
What is that on the bed?
Man, this could almost be art if it wasn't so fucking sick and disturbed.
Okay, I guess for want of a horse head, you do this. I guess it's effective enough. I mean, it's the same message, which is you're not safe in your bed or something like that.
My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there.
What's it? Weren't you gonna get dressed?
Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans.
Hey, Einstein left over had the
same exact suit for every day of the week. And he couldn't even rewind time.
How do you know? Also, is that like a leftover message from the first episode when you were looking for the flash drive?
My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there.
I guess it must be, because that doesn't really make sense to me any other way. Also, there's a schedule there. I guess I can't look at it right now.
Hold up. I need to find the book before going to see Kate.
Never mind. I forgot about the book. I guess that explains it. You know, I haven't read that much Bradbury myself. I have a few books lying around, but pretty much all I've read is Fahrenheit 451.
And nothing here.
I can tell by taking one look. I have eagle eyes, you see. Oh, there we go.
Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. Better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems.
Yeah, that happens to me sometimes, but fortunately, when that happens to me, it's with empty glasses or bottles. So let's be careful this time.
Be gone, foul soft drink.
You're not really moving it that much, dude. You're still in danger.
Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine.
If you're gonna move it that little, you could just, you know, be not careful when reaching it instead of moving it at all.
As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now.
I guess. What
now
DVDs
have
are these?
I wonder if any of these films are based on a true story.
Okay, that doesn't really tell me anything, but well, I guess we're ready here. Oh boy. A private number message. Keep your smart mouth shut about everything or I'm coming for your ass. I know where you sleep. Oh boy.
Oh shit. Now I'm getting anonymous threats? It never ends. This has to be from Nathan.
But what if it isn't?
It could be anybody.
That's what I just said. Thanks for
around here, or I could repeating that. Serious danger.
It's alright.
Not already.
Well, I mean, they know where you sleep. They already told you that, but well, what does Brooke have to say?
There's Brooke, looking smarter than everybody.
Hey, Brooke. Oh, hi, Max.
Did you see the snow?
Did you see the freak snowfall yesterday?
I guess it
was
snow.
I was riddled by that weird snow flurry yesterday. I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm interested in science and I'm in high school, so therefore
explain that snow.
I'm a meteorologist.
Did you talk to him yet?
I guess I will later.
I will later. Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max. I'll see you around.
Okay. So I hello, keyboard. Thank you for okay, thank you for responding for 1 second, but then now thanks for making me have to restart you and then not have you being very responsive. Oh boy. Bear with me, folks. One moment. Okay, how about now? Okay, I guess that's better than nothing. So, where is Kate? Oh boy.
The marks of Satan.
I guess that's where Kate is, and they messed up her slate again, so guess what? It's time to redo this. Did this for in the first episode, but it was for a different message on the slate. So shall we be righteous again, or what? Thank you. Alright, we got one vote for, two votes for. Do it. I guess we know what we're doing. And now it's blank.
I sure would like to catch this hall tagger.
So let's go and give back the book.
Hey, you in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Matt.
Much like in other places, we can totally snoop around the room before we even talk to the owner.
Kate is all alone dealing with this video bullshit. I hope her mother doesn't disown her.
Oh boy. I hope you haven't brought shame on you and your family. That's a great thing to say. We need to pray for forgiveness. I hope you can bring honor to us all again.
Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week.
Well, I hope the walls are thick enough that that didn't bother anyone.
Kate's room is usually immaculate. For her, this must be a pigsty.
I guess.
Maybe Kate has a split personality. Church girl by day, party monster by night.
Well, it's not really clear at this point, but that's kind of implied by...
Kate even makes notes in her Bible. My parents never once took me to church. I had nothing to rebel against. I don't know what to believe now.
So there's a couple of marked passages here. Matthew 11:28, which is, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." And Proverbs 21:15, I think, or 24. "Injustice is done," freaking cursive, "it brings joy to the righteous, but terror to the evildoers." So, you know, it might be a good idea to keep that in mind, what passages those are.
Damn, it's the all-American zombie family.
I guess.
Kate's room is usually
immaculate. I'll look at this.
For her, this must be a pigsty.
Well, what about the other side? A cloth over the mirror. Oh boy.
Why did she cover up the mirror? She can't look at herself?
Well, I don't blame her, I mean. I don't really favor mirrors myself.
Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive.
Really? If you say so. Once again, I cannot comment on art in any real capacity. Oh boy, what do we have?
Kate really has a doting father.
The light shines in darkness. So, Dad loves her, but Mom not so much by the looks of it.
That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through boxes.
Maybe she has a cold. I mean, do you know how many tissues I've used the past week?
I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella.
Well, now you do. No, I'm not sure if that was the correct response. Oh well.
Hey, I'm trying to use my powers for good.
Okay, I guess Jesus is judging her.
That is the cutest bunny ever. I bet Kate is a good mommy.
Well, let's photograph the rabbit. I hope it doesn't mind the light. And I hope Kate doesn't mind that we came in to return her book and she's kind of brooding at the desk and we're photographing her rabbit instead of talking to her.
Ouch. She left out damnation.
Oh boy. What does that say? "No spirit or devil could have prepared me for..." Well, I can just do this, screw it. "What you have done in that videotape, oh boy. You released your harlot image before God's eye. You must be saved from the eternal hellfire. Love, Auntie." Isn't that nice?
Good lord.
Oh god.
This must be Kate's H.R. Giger period.
Pretty sure it's Giger, but okay.
It's way too emo in here. Kate isn't that gloomy. Until lately.
Well, the Blinds kind of suck if they let in this much light. We can look at the photo. I thought we were gonna photograph something else.
It looks like when she smiles.
How long has it realistically been since you saw that, though?
Poor Kate. She doesn't look good.
Alright, let's talk to her.
Hey, Kate. I brought your book.
Max, why didn't you do anything when you harassed me yesterday?
Well, we do have an explanation for this. But I guess we might give our rationale.
I wanted proof David was in your face.
I thought he was different. I'm happy to see that somebody cares.
Oh, that was quick.
Hey, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Well, why?
Why does he think that?
Because he saw the video. You know how humiliating this is for me?
Well, I haven't seen it.
But tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
Well, the only things I generally don't have any memory of is sometimes when I fall asleep and my dog is in the room, and when I wake up, she's not in the room anymore, but I'm guessing that's because I opened the door for her when I was half asleep, but what happened is what I would ask. That's awful. Can you explain that?
That's awful. So, how did that happen?
It's a long story. I'm still trying to sort it all out.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Are you sure? Well, I think that's implying that we think she's lying, so let's say something's fishy here.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Oh boy. And did you?
Did you go?
Definitely not. I'm not sure where I went.
What do you remember about that?
All I recall is driving for a long time. And I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on.
Oh man.
I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice.
Was there always music
in
the air?
I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And that's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Well,
thanks, Max.
Is it really a viral video if only people you know in real life know about it? I mean, as long as 4chan doesn't take an interest in it, I think you're good to go. Also, what do we do? We leave it in the bag, I guess. Or not in the bag. But
so, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party.
I think we know.
Should I go to the police?
I don't think that's a good idea, but well, it's kind of been implied. I don't know if it's been specifically implied, but it's pretty much all but stated that the police are in in the Prescott's pocket since they're a rich family, so. So, you know, time to make this decision. What was I playing? Oh yeah, it was this thing. Okay, maybe not. But not like it really mattered, because I see we have two votes for look for proof. So let's do it. Let's tell her to do that.
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, no, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Good job, Dr. Max.
12.
She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened.
Okay, that for once didn't actually seem to suggest you should go back and do the other one, or at least not poignantly, I guess. It's more of a should do the other one if it makes you feel good, even though you know it's wrong. So.